Hey guys, this is Aaron. I want to take a look at a practice you may be interested in. I have a custom template set up right here for conceptual modeling. So that means I have a bunch of stuff preset in this model when I first open it to facilitate a specific kind of modeling, in this case, conceptual architectural modeling. So a couple things. One, as I start drawing here, if you look down lower right corner as I draw, you can see that all my dimensions are jumping 1 foot at a time. So I actually have my unit set right now. If I come in here to model info, I can show this to you. Units is set to snap to 1 foot. So as I draw, everything is going to jump to 1 foot. This means when I get finished with my model, I'll have some pretty round numbers on here rather than, you know, a bunch of fractions or small dimensions that I don't want to work with. The other thing I have is you can see my style is set to kind of a sketchy style. This is not necessary, of course, but kind of something I like working in. It makes it feel like it's, you know, temporary. This is not a final polished drawing. This is conceptual as I work through here. I can tell that just by looking at it. The other thing is I have a bunch of components that I can quickly use. So I can quickly snap windows in rather than having to model them. I can just throw these on the wall where I need them. Got some doors in here. Things I want to pull in is reference. So I can see that maybe this is where I'm intending to park the car. A little bush that I want to put out front. And a big pink gorilla that goes on the top. You know, just the important stuff. I can actually have those components already saved so I can quickly throw them in. The other thing is once I get these items to the point where I want to group them or put them into a layer, I already have layers here too. So I create group my first floor here, and then I can just go up here and real quickly say this is first floor. So all of that is already in the template from the start. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go start a new template, walk you through this real quick. All right, so I'm gonna start with this brand new model, default template right now, and I'm just gonna walk through those different things to change. So I'm gonna come in here, go to model info, and look at my units first. Now normally if I'm drawing an architectural building, I would be fairly precise in 16th inches, probably what I'd use. In this case though, I'm gonna set my precision to a little bit bigger number, and I'm gonna set my snapping a lot bigger. Now snapping doesn't mean you can't draw other dimensions, it just means as I drag my mouse along, so say drawing a line, it's just gonna jump to the nearest foot rather than some small odd increment. All right, next thing I might consider is changing my style. This, of course, is not absolutely necessary. This is a preference thing, but if I wanna come in and get like a sketchy edges style like that as I do conceptual, that's something I might wanna choose. Layers, if I come in here for layers, I can just add real quick. And when I save this template, it's going to save that layer information. And then finally, what I would consider probably the most useful tool is loading a bunch of components in. Components are great because it lets me automatically add details and geometry that I'm going to add to every building I build or every model I create just by dragging and dropping. I can do this a couple different ways, of course. I could come in and draw up the things I want. So if I wanted a window, for example, I could come in and go through the process of drawing a window, setting the size, everything. That's great, save it. As a component, it'll show up my components, or this is a spot where I can really leverage 3D Warehouse. So if I come in here and I look for something like I can find a window, this one looks good. I like this. I'm going to download it into my model. All right, and there we go. I have it in the model now. I don't have to actually have it on the screen to be a component. I can actually load it in once, and then once that's in there, it'll actually be part of the component. Now, it's real important at this point that I don't go in to model info, statistics, and click purged. Purge will delete everything that's not actually in the model screen. So that means any of my components that are unused, any of my layers, styles, anything that's not actually being used currently will get thrown out. So I want to make sure I don't click that. I did get a couple extra layers in here from that import. So I'm just going to come in here and delete these layers. Now I can come up to File and Save as Template. And I'm just going to call this Concept. This is my concept model. And I'm going to save. I did have save as use as default set, so when it starts a new model, I'm going to have this one. I can change that, of course, at any time by going to SketchUp, Preferences, or in Windows, it's Windows Preferences. And I can come in here and I can see all of my stock templates, but at the very bottom, also all of my user-created templates. So these are the ones I just set up. So I can actually come in here and make sure, pick or change which template I want to use when I create a new model. Thank you.